Hello, loves. I'm Coach Kara. Welcome back. And today we are doing another video regarding black men versus black women, their divide when it comes to dating or having relationships. So this video will actually piggyback off of my previous video, and I'll try to put that in the cards above. Okay, guys, so listen. So as most of you know, that over the recent years, there's been like this war between black men and black women, you know, pointing blame and that sort of thing, right? So listen, so while I was on chill scrolling through YouTube, and in one of my recommendations, there was this guy's video. I guess he's like a vlogger or whatever. And it was just a preview of the video. And he was showing a clip of a cute white guy with a big personality talking about why black men don't deal with black women anymore. All right. And so the white guy goes on to say, and yeah, black men don't, you know, mess with black women anymore because most of them are overweight. They're like 180 pounds. And if they could just put down the fried chicken and yada, yada, yada. So I'm like, whoa, pause. Right. So I actually click on the video so I could check out the comments, you know, as we all do. And so as I'm scrolling along, to my surprise, the comments that were made by black men, our brothers, against black women were incredible. Like, I could not believe the level of criticism, you know, hate against black women. And they were actually co-signing with this guy, right? Not saying that what he was saying wasn't factual, you know, at some percentage. It was the way it was being conveyed, you know. Any woman of color would be highly offended by the way he was putting that out there. And we have these new age modern day Negroids down in the comment section agreeing with him, not realizing when he's speaking of black women, not a particular group, but labeling all black women, including their grandmothers, their mothers, their aunts, their sisters, they're going along with this. And this is why I'm doing this video. And so I have been seeing a lot of this sort of hatred on social media, more specifically with Instagram. So you look into the comments, and the things that black men and black women are saying against each other. You know, black men are lazy. They don't take initiative. And black women have too many children and yada, yada, yada. And this is the only type of negative behavior I see amongst black people. Like, it's a rarity where I see another white person say something, you know, really derogatory or offensive towards their own kind. If anything, they'll state a fact. You know, it's not really offensive. It's just more factual than anything. But I never see this with Asians, especially Hispanics and Mexicans. You don't see that. You see loyalty, regardless of what they think about the person, right? And this is where we are. Are black men and black women truly that divided? So I began to ponder on this matter and began to think deeply of what the root problem, because there's always a cause for something. And so you typically see this sort of behavior with those who are unhealed. They still have unresolved trauma, you know, unresolved, unhealed pain, and they're deflecting, they're lashing out upon whomever, whenever. So they're down in the comments and you're this and you're that, and you could get a man, a black man, if you just did this, if black women didn't, you know, it's a lot of pointing fingers and blaming when in actuality, where you need to begin is taking accountability for your poor choosing of a partner. So if you chose someone, regardless if you're male or female, and you decided to overlook those red flags and those telltale signs that this person isn't going to be ish in the next few months, and you decide to go up the phone because you want someone to like you, whatever your reasoning is, That's on you. You need to be held accountable for that. You made a poor decision to be with that type of individual. So what that means is that not everyone else of that same sex is going to be like that. See, when you're healed or healed enough, because we never completely healed, and that remaining percentage is there to remind you of what you should and should not do or accept, right? Okay, so when you've reached a certain level of healing, you don't see people and a negative manner. You just don't. I went through my healing process and I see people differently. Okay, so for example, with myself, I have a thing for nose, like really nice noses. So if I see a guy who has what I would consider like a bell pepper or a pushback nose, I overlook that and say to myself, oh wow, he has a really nice smile or an amazing personality. I don't bash him. Or if I see something to where I know he could work on it, I would say, okay, maybe he would be a better guy if he just did this. You know what I'm saying? So you look at other people from a different perspective, in a positive light. See, you guys out here spewing all this hatred and you're berating one another, making us all look bad. What happened to Black love and Black Lives Matter and yada, 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 and all that other bullshit? So we're coming against each other successfully. We are proudly and successfully pulling each other apart instead of lifting each other up. And see, I think the primary reason why you guys are just going, you're all over the place, is because you don't know why someone is the way they are. Why this young lady has two or three children by two different dads. Perhaps she fell in love with the guy because the guy promised her everything. You know, after a certain period of time, maybe you become a little less responsible and stop using protection because you now trust this individual. Now, what if that guy decided to leave her for someone else or just leave altogether? Now she's just left there. Time goes on, she meets someone else, same thing happens. She puts her heart out there. And the one thing about women is women can love over and over again, you know, regardless of how much she's been hurt, because she's looking for love. And when she doesn't get that, well, this is the end result. Okay, so you can't just assume that all Black women are a certain way, that we're all angry. Black men are angry too. We have our own reasons though. We need to start uplifting each other and stop looking down on people. That's the main thing. We need to stop looking down on people. I remember when I was thinking about this, a couple of years ago, I was watching this blogger on YouTube and, you know, he shares his life, you know, his dating life or whatever. And he met this girl, you know, he's big into fitness and beautiful personality, beautiful Black woman, everything that he was really looking for, right? The only thing is he was a little, you know, whatever about her weight. So she was like 10 to 12 pounds overweight. So instead of berating her and criticizing her or just dumping her for, you know, a stick figure, what he did was he helped her because turns out she was a snacker because she was bored. She had single, nothing to do. So that's what she did. That's how she put on the weight. He worked her out for 2 months. He showed this. Took her around the track, put her in the gym. Guess what? 2 months later, her body was banging. So now, not only did he have a beautiful Black woman with an amazing personality, well-established, he also had someone who was well on the journey of being more fit. That is called uplifting. You uplift someone. It doesn't even have anything to do with race, but we always try to uplift instead of criticize. You understand? Maybe she was a little depressed. Who knows why she had that extra weight on her? And if we could all do this, then we would be more accepting of each other. But instead, we like to talk bad about our own kind. I've never seen that against any other race. But then again, let's go back to the beginning, right? You know, how did our own slave, you know, in slavery, we were traded by our own people to the colonists. So that lack of loyalty has always been there from the beginning. Yeah. We have to learn to stop judging people. You don't know why someone is the way they are or what has happened. I see people all the time. I could say something very critical, but I don't. I always look for the good in someone. I remember one morning I was trying to cut across, trying to avoid traffic, but it was like through this not so good area. And as I'm driving down the street, I noticed this young girl. It was just like just us two. And as she was walking up, she was kind of dressed well, you know, looked biracial, but young. Not only was she young, maybe 16, 17, she looked zooted, like she was out of it. I'm like, oh, whoa, what's going on? Now, someone else may have said, now, what is she doing out here this time of morning on the streets, yada, 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 you know, ready to bash the girl. But what I did was I stopped and I rolled my window down and I said, hey, love, I'll be praying for you. And she said, okay, thank you. She nodded. Do you know that affected me so bad for a very long time? I cried all the way to my destination. I called my guy who I was with at the time, who was working, and was explaining the situation. He was like, well, I know you like to help everybody, but you don't know what kind of situation she's in, you know, if she has a pimp or something like that, or someone's watching her. So, you know, I understand you want to help, but just pray for it. And I've been praying for that girl. That was like over 10 years ago. I've been praying for her ever since. Why? Because instead of judging her, I found a way to hopefully encourage her to go back to her grandmother or wherever she was a little bit more safe than where she was. You understand? So we have to get out of this mindset that, oh, this type of person, they're going to hurt me because this certain way, because they're from this type of, you know, hood or whatever. They look like this. That's not true. There are many women out here with at least 2 to 3 children who are very well established, educated. It just so happened they met the wrong person as far as trying to have a family with. These sorts of things happen. It's happened to you. So when a girl has bashed you out about not being more motivated and trying to do and be more ambitious like those other guys comparing you, was it because you were depressed? You lacked self-esteem, you have poor confidence? It has to be something, and that's nothing to smile about. So when you're with someone and they don't understand that, of course it's easy for them to name call you and make you feel even worse about yourself. So I think it's all about a matter of knowing why someone is the way they are or what they have going on and trying to understand that. Uplifting people. We have to continue to uplift. You have no idea of the amount of people who are walking around today with mental health challenges, and no one knows about it. That's scary. And I think a lot of people who are sitting behind the keyboard or doing some little thumb action on the phone in the comment sections are going through something, and you need to talk to someone. Yeah, you need to find a way to heal. Disassociate yourself from everyone and everything. Go into solitude and do some deep self-reflection. And introspection. Yeah. That's how you get past all of that hate, that negativity. And you try to see the best in other people. This way you'll feel better. And the funny thing is, the guy who actually had the video up, the moment I saw him, there were so many things I could have said about him that was negative. But I didn't. Like in my head, but I just overlooked that and continued to do what my mission was, right? Yeah. I could have said a lot of things that were negative, but I chose not to. And I always have a lot of stories. I've met a lot of people in my life, had a lot of experiences. And so I remember one time I was in high school. We moved to like the other side of town, right? And there was these two brothers that lived across the way from us. Turns out a few months later, we discovered that they were actual drug dealers. Now, one would have not known just by looking at them, looking at the nice house, how great they kept the yard, that sort of thing. There was never any traffic, any family, no visitors, hardly ever, right? So you wouldn't have known that. And I would always speak, never spoke to them. Fast forward, I would say like 7 years ago, I ran into one of the brothers at a birthday party. And he was like, oh yeah, you're that girl who used to stay across the street and you dated such and such and da da da. And I'm like, yeah. You know, small talk. And I'm like, are you good now? And he knew exactly what I meant. He said, I am. He said, I'm good. He said, all that stuff you see me doing, he said, I did that because so I can own my own barbershop. He said, I've been a barbershop owner for 10 years. I went to school, did the whole bit. I have my employees. I have my 2 little girls. I'm good. I'm blessed. And I was like, wow. See, you don't ever know why someone's doing something. And I never prejudged him. I could have said a lot of things. You're making the neighborhood look bad, that sort of thing. But I never thought that. And when he said that, you know, he's looking me deep in my eyes. And I say, I am so proud of you. I'm very proud of you. And he became teary-eyed. And I was like, whoa. He said, no one's ever told that to me before. Yeah. And I brought him in for a hug. Like, look, keep it going. And by me saying that, hopefully that would give him enough motivation to continuously doing that. Because, you know, things happen in life. You have a hiccup and you may want to backslide. So hopefully me telling him that he's proud, it uplifted him in a way so he never wants to go back to that lifestyle. See, it's all about uplifting people, especially your own race. You never know what just small words like that could do for someone. And here we are, very proudly and openly just dismissing each other, which is insane. Oh my gosh, guys, the comments that I've seen is just crazy. And I don't see anything dating outside of your race. Look, love has no bounds. It doesn't discriminate. Love is love. But the issue that I have with that is when you get with a race, let's just say a Caucasian, and then you talk about your own race. Oh, I don't date them because they are this and they do these sorts of things and they're, you know, mad and angry, yada, yada, yada. All those things that you're saying, that individual may be sitting there thinking like, well, I know exactly what you mean. My grandfather, my great grandfather thought the same thing about you people, but you're a different type of black person. You know, just say, I'm dating you. I'm dating you now. You know, I'm trying something different. We don't have to degrade our, or anyone for that matter. Like, we're all humans. Or at least some of us are. We're starting to really slowly turn into savages. Like heartless savages. And it's crazy. Yeah? So you don't have to berate anyone to make yourself look better. Or so that they will like you more. That's still negative. I wouldn't even want to be with someone like that. Okay? You're disrespecting your own race. Okay, so I'm going to see what the loyalty with us is like later on. You understand? So it's that sort of thing. Yeah, it's quite sad that, you know, others, great other Black Americans have done so much to keep us together. Like Harriet Tubman running through swamps and sleeping in trees, trying to bring us all together. But yet so many of you Black people are doing everything in your power to keep us apart. So when you find yourself on other platforms and it's like men versus women, and you're chiming in, just think to yourself, is this person really helping you? Are they being positive? Are they giving you a solution to help the problem instead of hurt it? Think about that. Think about what type of person that is. And why are you listening to that type of person? But hey, you do your own thing. You believe in what you believe in, yeah? But it's quite shameful. Yeah. Shame on you. And I'm going to just leave all of that right here for now. I thank you for joining me. Until next time.